Did you ever dream of buried treasure? Of lonely pirate coves? Of maps with skull and crossbones? Treasure, they say, is where you find it. And the whole universe is one vast, overflowing treasure chest. Treasure hunting can be fun. And the heart of the earth is known to be a storehouse of endless treasure. A result of an ample supply of molecules, even temperature, and centuries of time. The treasure has drawn men as by a strong magnet into the dark recesses of the earth. Cave explorers. Speleologists, they're called. Spelunkers, if you know them well. Their search is not for gold, but for the elusive gem of knowledge. To be where man has never been before. To know the unknown. Cave exploring can be a hazardous occupation. Always there's a danger of falling into the unknown depths below. An underground stream can suddenly become a raging torrent, cutting off all escape. Careful spelunkers maintain communication with the surface for a constant check on the weather. In certain areas of the world, subterranean rivers have cut huge caverns deep within the earth. In some places, the underground erosion is so extensive, the caves may never be completely explored. The gloom that seems to accompany the darkness of the underground has never retarded the scientist in his search for knowledge. Whatever the risk, he must find what there is at the bottom. Grotesque figures which lend such an eerie quality to limestone caves are formed by water, not by tumbling torrents, but quietly through the passing centuries. Limestone is somewhat soluble in rainwater because rain falling through the air undergoes a slight chemical change to become a mild form of acid solution. And then as the water seeps down through the earth, and comes into contact with the limestone deposit, the water itself becomes saturated with the dissolved mineral. And here we find the tool responsible for the crystalline beauty so often found in the grottos of the earth. A drop of water. While each shimmering drop hangs for a fleeting second, it evaporates imperceptibly, leaving behind a few molecules of limestone. And through the centuries, the resulting crystals form the stalactite from above. Similar action forms the stalagmite on the floor of the cave. Crystals built of invisible molecules. Molecules that are built of atoms. Atoms that are tiny universes. Speaking of treasure, look at this. Well, you probably think I mean the steak, but how about the salt? Sodium chloride. one tiny grain is composed of billions upon billions of particles so small that if we put a million of them in a pile, we couldn't even see the pile, not even with a microscope. If we put a drop of water on that grain of salt, warmed the slide just a bit, we find that something happens to the salt. It's dissolving. Millions of those tiny invisible particles are breaking away from the grain of salt and mixing with the molecules of water. So the salt grain just disappears. But now as the slide is cooling, let's turn to a higher power. When the water cools just enough, scores of tiny little gems appear as from nowhere. Millions upon millions of invisible salt molecules reunite to form microscopic crystals with such precision that science can measure no flaw in the perfection of their crystal surfaces. Table salt, treasure in the commonplace. With the microscope, the medicine chest can become a treasure chest, each substance having its own jeweled magic. In cough syrup, you may find terpenhydrate, which produces long, slender crystals that form at precise angles, which identify these crystals from all others. A soothing eye wash may contain zinc acetate, each crystalline substance producing its own characteristic crystal, the basis of that beautifully exact science, microchemistry. Oxalic acid forms a tumbling jumble of microscopic jackstraws. Hydroquinone, a forest of shimmering needles. Frost on a window pane? No. Sparkling jewels of ammonium chloride. Most crystals are microscopic in size, but there are exceptions. Rock candy starts as invisible sugar molecules which build together to form microscopic sugar crystals. If there's an ample supply of sugar molecules and a constant temperature, the crystals will grow almost indefinitely. You may have seen these giant sugar crystals in a jar of jelly left on a forgotten cellar shelf. This is a natural crystal of optical calcite, just as it came from the ground. As it was forming deep in the earth, the molecules were more tightly compressed on one axis than on the other. And so it has what is called a double index of refraction. That is, it splits a beam of light. Two prisms made of this strange material, added to a good microscope, will reveal the growth of microscopic crystals under polarized light. Let's take a pinch of trionol. Cover it with a cover slip. And then heat it until it melts into a thin film of liquid. And then watch that liquid under the microscope. The individual molecule of trionol could never be seen. So at first, nothing is visible. But as the liquid cools, millions upon millions of molecules become less active and group more closely together. This rearrangement of the molecules is responsible for the liquid becoming a visible solid. Thank you. With some chemicals, the crystals form very slowly. With others, they form almost instantly. And they're all different because the molecules from which they're formed are different. The ability of each crystal to divide polarized light into its component colors makes it possible for us to witness this unending variety of beauty. But within the beauty of this symphony of colors lies a treasure, a gem of knowledge. Two prisms made of this strange material, added to a good microscope, will reveal the growth of microscopic crystals under polarized light. Let's take a pinch of trionol. Cover it with a cover slip. And then heat it until it melts into a thin film of liquid. Two prisms made of this strange material, added to a good microscope, will reveal the growth of microscopic crystals under polarized light. Let's take a pinch of trionol. Cover it with a cover slip. And then heat it until it melts into a thin film of liquid. These crystals, formed from chemicals that once were in solution, have been created with a geometric precision totally beyond the efforts of man. Formed over such a staggering number of years that only an infinite patience could see such a project to its end. And only a master designer could have thought of the countless patterns we see in the beautiful crystals. Crystals built of invisible molecules. Molecules that are built of atoms. Atoms that are tiny universes. More of them in a single crystal than there are stars in all the known universes of space. No matter whether man searches up or down, he finds a wonder-working hand has gone before. The uniformity of the molecular structures responsible for this crystalline beauty could not have happened by accident. Knowing this, we must stand in awe at the majesty of God's creation.